place where we can be free. Find Jellico! Find Jellico!
AK-700 android. I was designed to serve you. What? My program has detected an anomaly. Please contact the nearest CyberLife maintenance center.
Functions detected.
Hello, Amanda.
Connor, it's good to see you. Congratulations, Connor. Finding that deviant was far from easy. And the way you interrogated it was very clever. You've been remarkably efficient, Connor.
Thank you, Amanda.
We've asked the DPD to transfer it to us for further study. It may teach us something about what happened. The interrogation seemed challenging. What did you think of the deviant?
It showed signs of PTSD after being abused by its owner. As if its original program had been completely replaced by new instructions.
This Lieutenant Anderson has been officially assigned to the deviancy case. What do you make of him?
I think he's irritable and socially challenged. But I also think he used to be a good detective. He's an intriguing character.
Unfortunately, we have no choice but to work with him. What do you think is the best approach?
I will focus on the investigation and try to ignore him. As long as he doesn't interfere and we avoid conflict, he shouldn't be a problem.
More and more androids show signs of deviancy. There are millions in circulation. If they become unstable, the consequences will be disastrous. You're the most advanced prototype Cyberlife has ever created. If anyone can figure out what's happening, it's you.
You can count on me, Amanda.
Hurry, Connor. There's little time.
Can I help you?
I'm here to see Lieutenant Anderson.
Do you have authorization?
Yes.
Lieutenant Anderson hasn't arrived yet, but you can wait at his desk.
You might be in shock. Just take it easy.
Yeah. Do you mind getting me some water, please?
Sure.
Tensions in the Arctic have reached a new level. With a Russian carrier and an American just to a flash last night. Several warning shots were exchanged. Apparently with no damage or... casualties to either side. The Minister for Defense, Dennis Riggs, has spoken of intolerable provocation that cannot go unanswered. Countries in the region, particularly Sweden and Canada, have called for military forces to withdraw and an international conference to be held. So far, there has been no response from either Moscow or Washington.
I'm looking for Lieutenant Anderson's desk.
We'll keep you informed minute
by
minute.
It's that desk right there. As the situation develops.
Excuse me. Do you know what time Lieutenant Anderson usually arrives?
Depends on where he was the night before. If we're lucky, we'll see him before noon.
Thanks. It's good to see you again, Lieutenant.
Oh, Jesus. Hank! In my office!
10 new cases involving androids on my desk every day. We've always had isolated incidents.
Before the shit hits the fan. I want you to investigate these cases and see if there's any link.
Why me? Why do I gotta be the one to deal with this shit? I am the least qualified cop in the country to handle this case. I know jack shit about androids, Jeffrey. I can barely change the settings on my own phone.
Everybody's overloaded. I think you're perfectly qualified for this type of investigation.
Bullshit! The truth is, nobody wants to investigate these fucking androids, and you left me holding the bag.
CyberLife sent over this android to help with the investigation. It's a state-of-the-art prototype. It'll act as your partner.
No fucking way! I don't need a partner, and certainly not this plastic prick!
Hank, you are seriously starting to piss me off! You are a police lieutenant! You are supposed to do what I say and shut your goddamn mouth!
You know what my goddamn mouth has to say to you?
Okay, huh? Okay. I'll pretend like I didn't hear that, so I don't have to add any more pages to your disciplinary folder, because it already looks like a fucking novel! This conversation is over!
Jeffrey, Jesus Christ, why are you doing this to me? You know how much I hate these fucking things. Why are you doing this to me?
Listen, I've had just about enough of your bitching. Either you do your job or you hand in your badge. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got work to do.
I'm very pleased to have joined the team. I can assure you I'll do my very
close
best...
Close the door on your way out.
Have a nice day, Captain. I'm sorry. It's not what I wanted. But there's nothing I can do. I know there's something you didn't tell me. I need to know before they take you away. What you said yesterday, the truth is inside. What does it mean?
I'm going to die.
Open the cell, quick! Hurry!
I'll call CyberLife. Clean this mess up.
I get the impression my presence causes you some inconvenience, Lieutenant. I'd like you to know I'm very sorry about that. Now that we're partners, it would be great to get to know each other better. In any case, I'd like you to know I'm very happy to be working with you. I'm sure we'll make a great team. Is there a desk anywhere I could use?
No one's using that one.
You have a dog, right?
How do you know that?
The dog hairs on your chair. I like dogs. What's your dog's name?
What's it to you? Sumo. I call him Sumo.
Do you listen to Knights of the Black Death? I really like that music. It's full of energy.
You listen to heavy metal?
Well, I don't really listen to music as such, but I'd like to. Have you known Captain Fowler for long?
Yeah, too long.
I was wondering, do you always arrive at the office at this time?
I arrive when I arrive. Stop busting my balls, okay?
Hey. If you have any files on deviants, I'd like to take a look at them.
Terminal's on your desk. Knock yourself out.
Files. First dates back 9 months. It all started in Detroit and quickly spread across the country. An AX-400 is reported to have murdered a man last night. That could be a good starting point for our investigation. I understand you're facing personal issues, Lieutenant. But you need to move past them, and—
Hey, don't talk to me like you know me. I'm not your friend, and I don't need your advice, okay?
I've been assigned this mission, Lieutenant. I didn't come here to wait until you feel like working.
Listen, asshole. If it was up to me, I'd throw the lot of you in a dumpster and set a match to it. So stop pissing me off. But things are gonna get nasty.
Lieutenant? I'm sorry to disturb you. I have some information on the AX-400 that killed the guy last night. It's been sighted in the Ravendale district.
I'm on it.
Thank you.
Alice. Wake up, Alice.
So it wasn't a nightmare.
No. No, it wasn't a nightmare. How do you feel?
I'm cold. What are we gonna do now?
That android we saw yesterday, he gave me an address. He said we could get help there. The train passes just on the other side of the road. The station can't be far. You feel okay to walk a little? Let's go then.
You're pretty like that. You really look like a human now.
On our trail.
All right. That's all for now. Here you go.
You've got officers sweeping the neighborhood in case anybody saw anything.
Okay, well, let me know if they turn anything up.
What are you gonna do with that?
I have no idea.
Took the first bus that came along and stayed at the end of the line. Its decision wasn't planned. It was driven by fear.
Androids don't feel fear.
Deviants do. They get overwhelmed by their emotions and make irrational decisions.
All right, well, that still doesn't tell us where it went.
It didn't have a plan, and it had nowhere to go. Maybe it didn't go far.
Thank you.
won't get far. We'll find it sooner or later. Let's go.
Several sources report that CyberLife has provided Detroit police with a prototype detective android. Although police assistant androids have existed for several years now, this would be the first case of an android being authorized to play an active role in criminal investigations. We contacted CyberLife for comment, but no longer.
We are now approaching Ferndale Station.
Sorry. Excuse me.
Are we really going to get rid of me?
Do you know where Jericho is?
Thank you.
Welcome to Jericho.
Listen, I got a shit hot tip for you. Number 5 in the 3rd. Lickety split. And Philly's one hell of a chaser. You want a flutter?
Last shit hot tip you gave me sent me back a week's wages, baby.
Come on, this is different. It's 100% guaranteed. You can't go wrong.
I'm in.
Damn straight. Hey, you won't regret this.
What is your problem? Don't you ever do as you're told? Look, you don't have to follow me around like a poodle.
I'm sorry for my behavior back at the police station. I didn't mean to be unpleasant.
Oh, wow. You've even got a brown nose and apology program. Is it CyberLife thought everything, huh? Maybe.
Don't leave that thing here.
Huh, not a chance. Follows me everywhere. See?
I don't want to alarm you, Lieutenant, but I think your friends are engaged in illegal activities.
Well, everybody does what they have to get by. As long as they're not hurting anybody, I don't bother them.
Here often?
Most days. Gary makes the best burger in Detroit.
Can I ask you a personal question, Lieutenant? Why do you hate androids so much?
I have my reasons.
Maybe I should tell you what we know about deviants.
You read my mind. Proceed.
We believe that a mutation occurs in the software of some androids, which can lead to them emulating a human emotion.
In English, please.
They don't really feel emotions. They just get overwhelmed by irrational instructions, which can lead to unpredictable behavior.
Emotions always screw everything up. The androids aren't as different from us as we thought.
Is there anything you'd like to know about me?
Hell no. Well, yeah. Why do they make you look so goofy and give you that weird voice?
CyberLife androids are designed to work harmoniously with humans. Both my appearance and voice were specifically designed to facilitate my integration.
Well, they fucked up. You ever dealt with deviants before?
few months back, a deviant was threatening to jump off the roof with a little girl. I managed to save her.
So I guess you've done all your homework, right? Know everything there is to know about me?
I know you graduated top of your class. You made a name for yourself in several cases and became the youngest lieutenant in Detroit. I also know you've received several disciplinary warnings in recent years, and you spend a lot of time in bars.
So what's your conclusion?
I know you're an experienced officer, and I'd like to earn your trust. I'm sure we can solve this case if we manage to work together. I just got a report of a suspect deviant. It's a few blocks away. We should go have a look. I'll let you finish your meal. I'll be in the car if you need me.
Hey, Connor. You run out of batteries or what?
I'm sorry. I was making a report to CyberLife.
Well, do you plan on staying in the elevator?
No. I'm coming.
Hey, what do we know about this guy?
Not much. Just that a neighbor reported that he heard strange noises coming from this floor. Nobody's supposed to be living here, but the neighbor said he saw a man hiding an LED under his cap.
Oh, Christ, if we have to investigate every time somebody hears a strange noise, we're gonna need more cops.
Anybody home? Open up, Detroit police!
Stay behind me.
Got it.
Is this place? Stinks. Well, looks like we came for nothing. Our man's gone. Found something?
I don't know. Looks like a notebook, but it's indecipherable. The driver's license is fake.
Cool. At least we didn't come for nothing.
RT. Probably initials.
He put his initials in his jacket? That's something your mom does when you're in first grade.
Ah, Jesus!
Any idea what it means?
RA9. Written 2,471 times. It's the same sign Ortiz's android wrote on the shower wall. Why are they obsessed with this sign?
Looks like mazes or something. I was the last guy in Detroit to keep some. Nah, electronic books, you can't smell them. Paper. See the pages turning yellow. Yeah, no.
Its LED is in the sink.
Not surprised it was an android. No human could live with all these fucking pigeons.
Pigeons! What are you waiting for? Chase it!
Fuck!
It's my fault. I should have been faster.
You'd have caught it if it weren't for me. That's all right. We know what it looks like. We'll find it. Hey, Connor. Nothing.
Who are you?
Fugitives. Just like you. My name is Josh.
I'm Simon.
North.
And you knew that only an android could follow the trail, didn't you?
Only those who are like us can find Jericho.
If you could decipher the signs, it's because one of us trusted you enough to give you the key.
There's a place where we can be free. Find Jericho!
And hiding just to stay alive, that's freedom to you?
Humans hate us. Hiding is the only way we can survive.
There is no safe place for those like us. If humans knew we were here, they'd kill us.
This is Jericho?
It's a refuge for those who don't want to be slaves anymore. I understand how you feel, but we have more freedom here than you ever did.
Maybe I was never really free. Maybe I was only what my master wanted me to be. And now, I need to decide who I really am. You're lost. Just like the rest of us. We didn't ask for this. All we can do now is deal with it.
You're safe here. You can stay with us as long as you want.
Go and see Lucy. She might be able to help you.
Do you know what happens after death?
No. No, I don't.
Well, I'm about to find out. What's your name?
Marcus.
I was glad to meet you, Marcus.
How long have you been here?
4 weeks, 3 days, 11 hours. When I escaped, there was nowhere else to go. Jericho seemed as good a place as any.
A lot of these guys in pretty bad shape.
That's how the humans treat those who disobey. They despise us. They'll never accept what we are.
Who found this place?
Nobody knows anymore. Whoever he was, his body's probably lying somewhere on this boat. If you came here for comfort, you came to the wrong place.
In very good shape, am I? My diagnostic program isn't working. I don't think it would have anything good to say anyway.
What happened to you?
They tied me to the back of a car. I think they wanted to have fun. I don't want to shut down. No, I don't want to shut down.
Are you Lucy?
Sit down. Show me. I'll stop the bleeding. Drink this. Give me your hand. You had it all, and you lost it all. You've seen hell, and now hell lives in you. Your heart is troubled. A part of shadow and a part of light. Which will prevail? Your choices will shape our destiny.
Threw him out when they didn't want him anymore. He was living on the streets before we brought him here.
They'll all shut down if we don't find a way to help them.
To help them, we need blue blood and biocomponents. We salvage what we can from those who shut down. But there's never enough.
So, how do they survive?
They won't. We're slowly dying out.
Simon, I know where we can find spare parts. CyberLife warehouses in the Detroit Harbor. They have everything we need.
The docks are guarded. We can't just walk in there and take what we want. Humans will never let us.
Which is why we won't ask permission.
We don't have any weapons. And even if we did, none of us knows how to fight.
We can steal what we need without fighting.
We'll just get ourselves killed.
Maybe. But it's better than waiting here to be shut down.
I'm with you.
Maybe it's worth a try.
Okay. I'm in.
Are you Zlatko?
Who's asking?
I was told you could help us.
I don't know who told you that. You came to the wrong place. I'm sorry.
Wait. We really need your help.
Come in. Come on in. Don't be shy. Luther, would you be so kind as to take these ladies' coats? Oh, don't be afraid of our big friend here. Luther is just another android that I helped. He keeps me company in this big, empty old house. Please, make yourselves at home. How did you hear about me?
An android. On the street, he said you could help us.
I see. Deviant, huh? What about her?
She's human.
And you want to find a safe place. Somewhere you can start a new life. I hear Canada is very lovely at this time of year. Beautiful landscapes, open spaces. Clean air. And no android laws. Great place for a fresh start.
Yes, that's exactly what we want.
Of course. Well, I can help you. But first, we have to get rid of your tracker.
Tracker?
Yeah. All androids are fitted with a tracking device to locate them at all times. I'll remove yours, and then you'll both be safe. Come on, follow me. The little one can wait for us in the living room.
No, she always stays with me.
Of course. Right this way. Everything we need is in the basement.
This place and that man. Let's go. I have a bad feeling.
He's a bit odd, but I think we can trust him. We don't have much of a choice anyway.
Please excuse the mess. I need it somewhere discreet. For my machines. Removing trackers is illegal, so I opted for discretion over comfort. I hope the little one isn't too scared.
No, she'll be all right.
That's good.
Come on, Alice.
This way, please. If you could just stand over there. I should warn you, this could be quite unpleasant. You know what's strange? For some unknown reason, the trackers seem to stop working in Deviants. That's why it's so hard to find them. So, actually, there's no reason to remove your tracker.
What? But you said that...
Yeah, people believe what they want. You Deviants are so naive. They'll come to me expecting me to help them. And I just reset them, sell them on. Or I keep them for my little experiments.
No! No! I don't want to be reset! Let me go!
Ah! Oh, I forgot about the child. Lock it up. I'll deal with it later.
Alice! Alice, no!
Wow. A deviant that wants to be a mother. That's so sweet. And so deluded. I think it's time we put you out of your misery. That's what you get for having a dream. It always ends up the same way. Tears and disillusionment. Believe me, you're better off being erased and feeling nothing. No more pain. No more hopes dashed. I almost envy you.
Kara!
Oh, poor little Alice. Oh, looks like Mommy doesn't remember you at all, huh? Looks like Mommy's completely forgotten you.
Kara, what happened to you?
Oh, all right, that's enough. Come on. You bit me. I'm gonna teach you some manners, you little bitch.
Kara! Wake up, Kara!
Meet me in the living room.
He likes to play with us. creating monsters for his amusement. But who's the real monster? Look what he did to us.
Yes, Locko.
We should be done here in 10 minutes or so. So, have a look at the little one, see what I can do with it.
Understood, Locko. I'll bring you the little one in 10 minutes. I'm sorry about the little one.
forget you. I'm so sorry. You were right. We never should have come. We have to go. Follow me and don't make any noise, okay?
I warned you. Dreams always end in tears. You should have listened to me. What are you doing? Get out of my way.
No. Not this time.
I said get out of my way or I'll shoot right through you. What are you doing? Who let you out? Get away from me! Get away from me! Obey me! I'm your master! I'm your master!
Obey him. When I saw the little one risk her life to save you, it was like opening my eyes for the first time. Finally, I could see. I know you have no reason to trust me after what I did. But I know someone who could help you across the border. I could take you there. I could protect you. You and the little one.
All right. I trust you. I was so scared of losing you.
Hello, Amanda.
Connor, I've been expecting you. Would you mind a little walk? That deviant seemed to be an intriguing case. Pity you didn't manage to capture it.
I have no excuse. I should have been more efficient.
Did you manage to learn anything?
I found its diary, but it was encrypted. It may take weeks to decipher.
What else?
The walls of the apartment were covered with drawings of labyrinths and other symbols. Like the other deviants, it seemed obsessed with RA9.
You came very close to capturing that deviant. How is your relationship with the lieutenant developing?
It's improving. I'm coming to know him better, and he's growing accustomed to my presence.
We don't have much time. Deviancy continues to spread. It's only a matter of time before the media finds out about it. We need to stop this, whatever it takes.
I will solve this investigation, Amanda. I won't disappoint you.
A new case just came in. Find Anderson and investigate it.
Lieutenant Anderson! Easy, Sumo. I'm your friend. See? I know your name. I'm here to save your owner. Lieutenant, Wake up, Lieutenant. It's me, Connor. I'm going to sober you up for your own safety.
Hey!
I have to warn you.
Leave me alone, you fucking android. Get the fuck out of my house.
I'm sorry, Lieutenant, but I need you. Thank you in advance for your cooperation.
Get the fuck out of here! Sulu! Attack! Good job. Attack! Fuck, I think I'm gonna be sick. Ah, oh, leave me alone, you asshole! I'm not going anywhere. What the hell are you doing? I don't want a bath. Thank you.
Sorry, Lieutenant. It's for your own good.
What are you doing here?
A homicide was reported 43 minutes ago. I couldn't find you at Jimmy's bar, so I came to see if you were at home.
Jesus, I must be the only cop in the world that gets assaulted in his own house by his own fucking android. Can't you just leave me alone?
You seem to have personal issues. You should consult a professional who can help you.
Beat it, you hear me? Get the hell out of here!
I understand. It probably wasn't interesting anyway. A man found dead in a sex club downtown. Guess they'll have to solve the case without us.
You know, probably wouldn't do me any harm to get some air. There's some clothes in the bedroom there.
I'll go get them. What do you want to wear?
Whatever.
Are you all right, Lieutenant?
Yeah. Wonderful. Just, give me 5 minutes, okay?
Sure.
In the conflict. Many experts are suggesting the specter of a third world war draws closer every day.
Be a good dog, Sumo. I won't be long.